been registered on my mind all my life. The day we went to collect the paybooks of our dead comrades at our villas. I couldn't help thinking that these poor relics that were lying there, a couple of days before, they'd been happy-go-lucky, laughing, joking comrades, now they were here. I must admit that for quite a time, although we were hardened by this time, I was hardened, I was quite depressed. We took the roll call the next day as the information came in, and we discovered that the colonel had been killed, the adjutant had been killed, all four company captains had been killed, every other officer had either been killed or wounded, none came back. There was one corporal, that was myself, one last corporal, and 63 privates. These terrible casualties were not unique to our battalion. There were dozens of regiments who were in the same boat. The two things that have haunted me most are the day at O'Villas when I had to collect the paybooks, and when I left Bill Hubbard in no man's land behind the German lines, obviously dying. I was picked up and taken into their trench. And I had no sooner taken two or three steps down the trench when I heard, "Oh, hello, Raz, I'm glad to see you. This is my second night here." He said, "I'm feeling bad." And it was Bill Hubbard, one of the men we'd trained in England, one of the original battalion. I had to look at his wound, rolled him over, and I could see that it was probably a fatal wound. You can imagine what pain he was in. He was dripping with sweat. And after I'd gone about three shell holes, traversed that, had there been a path or a road, I could have done better. He pummeled me, put me down, I'd rather die, put me down. I was hoping he would faint. He said, "I can't go any further, let me die." I said, "If I leave you here, Bill, you won't be found. Let's have another go." He said, "All right then." But the same thing happened. He couldn't stand it anymore, and I had to leave him there.